In this video, we introduce a new interactive web portal for data from the Human Cell Atlas project. Specifically, bone marrow RNA sequencing data for 8 healthy individuals spanning over 100,000 cells. These data were obtained from the Human Cell Atlas Preview Datasets Viewer, in particular a census of immune cells, which includes both umbilical cord and bone marrow RNA sequencing data, collected initially for 530,000 cells. The analysis in which we process this data, integrate the data, visualize the data, and interpret the data is described in a recent paper in Experimental Hematology. This is provided in his advanced online publication, as shown here. We're not going to focus on the methods used in this particular analysis, however, we're going to focus on the web browser in this particular tutorial. There are 4 major areas which can be viewed for this browser. The first is focusing on only CD34 positive progenitor populations, in which a sub-analysis was performed to identify 18 independent sets of cells. These cells include hematopoietic stem cell progenitors, predicted multilineage progenitors, granulocytic specifying progenitors, monocytic and dendritic specifying progenitors, as well as lymphoid, including B cells, unknown lymphoid progenitors, T cell progenitors, erythroid cells, megakaryocytic cells, and associated intermediate progenitors. In this viewer, you can simply click on a heading below, and then the table below will sort to identify the genes which have the most specific expression in that particular cell population. In this case, we clicked on HSC, so we're identifying genes that are most specific to hematopoietic stem cells. In this case, the gene AVP was most specific. Second ranked was a gene called CRHBP. And you can quickly view what the predominant cells that express that gene are within this data set. You can actually select each one of these different cell populations, for example, HSCs, and you can hide that population or view it again to clarify where it is within this layout. This layout was generated by a tool called Spring from Alon Klein's group. In addition to this view, there are a number of other views, including a UMAP, high dimensionality reduction visualization, which allows you to look at the same cell populations, but laid out in a different way by this other tool. You can also look at what's called the donor view. And the donor view contains the same data, but now actually spanning all 35 distinct specified and progenitor cell populations. On the left are a set of default genes that are shown, which are going to display in various plots, either in the combined donor view, which is what we're looking at now, or the individual donor view. Each one of these dots represents a different individual, as you can see here. When you mouse over each individual cell, you'll see that it indicates what the donor, who the donor is, their age, and their gender. The expression levels of each individual gene are shown here. On average, for the entire population of cells, in this case, all 100,000 single cells, for all the populations indicated on the x-axis. You can change any one of these genes and view the profile of those genes within the context of all these cell populations. You can also select individual donors, and if you do this, you'll see at first a bar chart view, which shows the distribution of expression of a particular gene across all cells within that population. And you can do this, of course, for different donors. You can also change the visualization option, in this case, from box plot to bar plot. And now you can see the expression of individual cells within each individual donor. And again, you can switch between donors, and you can see the variation within or across donors. You can compare the expression of genes within specific clusters or across cross clusters in regards to specific donors to see what the variation in gene expression there is. And simply you change the cell populations you look at by selecting different cell populations in the top. And again, you can change the specific genes in this panel up on the left. More about this web portal can be found in the web portal description, along with a downloadable citation for each one of the papers, including the Cell Harmony paper. The Cell Harmony paper, Cell Harmony was the tool that was used to align data between these different donors in conjunction with our previously published tool, ICGS, or Iterative Clustering and Guide Gene Selection. And of course, more information can be found in the paper itself. Thank you very much. Have a good day.